and the Guild Art Gallery are pleased to announce an exhibition of eminent Indian artist Shri Sudhir Patwardhan. The name of the exhibition is Walking Through the Shoal City, Sudhir Patwardhan, a retrospective. The exhibition is curated by Miss Nancy Adajania. It's an honor to have such a beautiful gathering here. I would like to invite our guest, Dr. Pheroza J. Godrej, ma'am, Shri Adwaita Charan Garanayak, DZ NGMA, Shri Vilas Shinde, Shri Sudhir Patwardhan, Dr. Gieve Patel, Srimati Anita Rupavataram, Miss Nancy Adajania, Miss Shalini Sanai, to come on stage and to formally inaugurate the show by lighting the lamp. Seated, our chief guest and Director General of NGMA, Shri Adwaita Charan Garanayak, Director NGMA Mumbai, Dr. Gieve Patel, an eminent artist, poet, and playwright, Shri Vilas Shinde, Chairperson Advisory Committee of NGMA Mumbai, Shri Sudhir Patwardhan, artist himself, Miss Nancy Adjania, curator. Thanks to all. Thanks to host DG sir to felicitate Shri Sudhir Patwardhan by presenting a shawl and a rose. Dr. Gieve Patel by presenting a rose. Thank you, sir. Now I would request Director NGMA Mumbai to felicitate Dr. Pheroza Godrej, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Now I would request our Assistant Director, Sri Z.J. D'Souza, sir, to felicitate Ms. Nancy Adajania by presenting a rose. Thank you, sir. Now I would request our Curator, Sri M. Sankar, to come on the stage and felicitate Sri Vilas Shinde, our Advisory Committee Chairperson. Thank you. and Director NGMA Mumbai will felicitate DG sir by presenting a rose flower. And D'Souza sir will felicitate Director NGMA by presenting a rose flower. Thank you, sir. We are delighted to bring out, Mrs. Pheroza Godrej is an art historian, environmentalist, and author, having written books on history, travel, and painting. A renowned curator, Mrs. Godrej is the director of Pheroza Art Gallery in Mumbai, which she founded in 1971. She has co-written and co-edited a number of publications and is closely associated with the CSMVS and the Museum Society of Bombay, Dr. Bhavdas Ilad Museum, National Gallery of Modern Art, Indian National Trust for Art and Cultural Heritage, INTAC, and the Indian Council of Cultural Relations, ICCR. Mrs. Godrej has chaired a number of committees over the years. We are delighted to bring an exhibition booklet in English and Marathi that includes Sudhir Patwardhan's note on 20 of his paintings with an introduction by Nancy Adajania. These notes give one a glimpse into the context of each painting and the thought process of the making of these artworks. I would now like to request Mrs. Pheroza ma'am to come forward to release the English booklet and say a few words.
I'm amongst friends, I know that. It's a real privilege, and Sudhir and Dr. Anita and Dr. Adwaita, thank you so much you've actually honored me by inviting me here today, and all of the people here today, Sudhir, are here for you. It's your show. 40 years is, I don't know where the time went, but I'm really happy that I'm here today, as I was perhaps several other exhibitions over the last four decades. I also wish to thank Shanta, the support behind Sudhir, for always being there, medical career or no medical career. Shanta has been a true partner in this long journey, and I don't think, Sudhir, you could have gone very far without her. So, thank you. And many contemporaries of Sudhir, many senior artists who went to School of Art and are still in their professional life here with us today, and several other artists who have followed in the last 3 decades. I think we owe a lot to you as an art community, as those who appreciate contemporary Indian art, those who collect Indian art, and those who, more than anything else, value contemporary Indian art. And I'm greatly aware of the fact that when we started our careers in this field, we had art critics writing about us many times. It was not even under their own name. It was just by our art critic. Now, who was this faceless person who was talking about us? And then there was a movement that you must give recognition to those who write about Indian art. And then this lovely generation of Nancy Adajania, Ranjit Hoskote, and several others who came us to put us in a perspective of where we stand as artists, or indeed where India stands on the world stage now of contemporary Indian art. It's a turning point for all of us on the dais, in this hall, in this magnificent building, the Sir Kavasji Jahangir Hall, since more than now, touching 40 years as part of NGMA, Ministry of Culture. Yes, it wouldn't be wrong to say we have come a long way, but we have many, many more years to go. There are many speakers after me, but walking through the city, or the soul of the city, is there for all around, for all of us to see. We know the drama that is being played out in our city. It's like being in the middle of Bollywood. You go to sleep with one scenario and you get up with another. But that's the name of the game today, and we have to respect it. We're a democracy. That is the most important thing today. And because of this great gift that we've been given since 1947, this great gift to all adults, men and women, we got it at the stroke of a pen: democracy, shared values, truth, most importantly, treat your neighbor as you would like them to treat you. And I think what you see around us is that fabric of Bombay. It's, you can move horizontally in this city, you can move vertically in this city, and you can be anyone you want to be. Your dreams and your aspirations can be achieved, whether you're an artist, a musician, politician, teacher, child, adult, even those with disability. I'm very happy to see, finally, the ramp. So we are making progress, and it's a time to reflect backwards. It's a time to study where we are at the present and where we want to go in the future. It's pretty much in our hands. So let's not miss any opportunities and go forward in friendship, in understanding, and above all with respect, because it's very, very easy to lose that respect. And once you've got it, you have to cherish it. So Sudhir, my congratulations to you, my congratulations to the Government of India, National Gallery of Modern Art, Mumbai, to Nancy, to my successors, Vilas and your team of advisors. Sudhir and I shared the platform, I think about 10 years ago, to the director, Dr. Anita, to our dear friend, Gieve. Where would we be? Where would we be? And to Nancy?
At the NGMA.
We are at the NGMA. I want to end on a positive note. This exhibition has taken place at the NGMA today. That is there for all of us to see. And thanks to GOI, and thanks to NGMA, Delhi and Mumbai, for making this show possible. And thanks to the gallery that brings this show to Mumbai. I know how hard it has been for Shalini and her band of people. So thank you very much for allowing to make these few reflective remarks as a welcome address. And we're looking forward to all the activities. I believe there are several of them lined up with this show. So have a lovely evening when you walk around the show. And I hand you back to Shruti. Thank you, Shruti.
Thank you, ma'am. I would like to introduce Dr. Gieve Patel. Dr. Gieve Patel has studied medicine and practiced as a doctor in Mumbai for almost 40 years, till 2005. Gieve Patel has pursued many interests and is well known as a painter, a poet, a playwright, and art critic. He has been translating poems from the 17th century Gujarati poet Akho into English. Gieve Patel has also written three plays that include Princess, Shawaksha, and Mr. Behram. He is an acclaimed artist, and his artworks have been shown widely, nationally, and internationally. I would like to request Gieve sir to say a few words with us.
My honored friends on the dais and friends in the auditorium. I'm really deeply touched and honored to be sitting here with all of you and to have an opportunity to say something at Sudhir's opening. Whenever my friend Sudhir phones and says, "Hey, Gieve, 4 new paintings, come and see them," my immediate feeling is one of an anticipation of pleasure in the prospect of seeing these works. I sometimes think about this with some surprise. Pleasure. Is that the first word that most people, including myself, would associate with the viewing of a Patwardhan work? Not really. Certainly not the first word. I think there are many others which would come before that. So some of the words that would come to us are feeling of sympathy, observation, commitment, rigor, intellectual discipline, and even compassion. But pleasure? However, I think I should keep this word pleasure on the side for a while. I will come back to it later and allow myself to explore some of the others which I mentioned. And I think that the word commitment can take a lot with it. So let me just get down to that word. There are various levels of commitment in both Sudhir the person and Sudhir the artist. There's the commitment to place and time, which all of us, you know, have been observing for years and years. He is a painter of today, he is a painter of this city, and by contiguity, he's a painter of this country. And a very interesting phenomena happens as a consequence of this. You know that we are always told that art is a reflection of life. That when you live something, you observe it, and then it comes into a painting or a novel or whatever. But you know, the opposite is also true. After a while, once an artist's work has been present to you again and again, there comes a point when life begins to reflect art. And this you can see very easily if you travel by a local train between VT and Thane, or between Churchgate and Virar, and sometimes even long-distance train journeys. You look out of the window, you see hills and shantytowns on the hills, you see people, and suddenly you say, ah, a Sudhir Patwardhan painting. So this is the way in which life is beginning to copy art in your eyes. And this can only happen when the artist has a tremendous commitment to locality and time. There's the commitment to class distinctions. Sudhir's work is very inclusive, actually. Many people talk about working class in his works, but the middle class is also very strongly represented again and again, and is presented with equal sympathy. So, you know, you have an artist who is not class-bound in his representations. You know? He has the capacity to find sympathy with a whole strata of society, different stratas of society. Third, there's a commitment to the act of painting and to the act of displaying painting. I don't know how many of you know that one of the exercises that he has put himself through is to paint at an area near Thane, which is called Pokhran, and to paint in public there. And he puts his canvas there, and a small crowd of people assemble, and he continues to paint. And then these paintings are later collected and exhibited at the spots where he has painted, so that the people who actually observed him painting also see an exhibition of those works. Now, this is a commitment, you know, a double commitment to the painting and the display. And in a way, it is his way of reaching out beyond the confines of the studio into society as a painter. Again, another example is when he took a small exhibition, a fairly representative exhibition of contemporary Indian works, which traveled to various smaller cities in Maharashtra. Aurangabad and Sholapur and Kolhapur and various other places. And people who had never had an opportunity to see an original modern Indian painting for the first time had a chance to see an exhibition of that kind. And all of this has been recorded and documented and is an absolutely priceless example of reaching out. So, in a way, all these various commitments add up to a commitment to a life devoted to art, not just to picture making, but the fullness of engaging himself and his viewers in the commonality of sharing a vision. Now, from some of the other words I used, let me pick sympathy and compassion. I believe that both these come naturally to Sudhir. They are a part of his constitution as a person, as a human being. And for that very reason, he has to be very careful. and he's aware enough to be very careful. There's a constant act of distancing going on so that sympathy and compassion do not become weak and easy ways of actually dismissing human suffering. There's a way of reaching out, but also of checking and holding back. This is where the word rigor comes in. It is this discipline of rigor seen in painting after painting that accounts for the wonderful sense of sanity that these works emanate. How far you can enter into other people's lives, and when your respect for other people dictates that you should stop. A profound balancing act. A profound balancing act which takes years of effort to bring to the kind of perfection that we see in these works. And so, finally, I might allow myself to come back to my first word, which is the pleasure involved in seeing a Sudhir Patwardhan work. This is the ultimate magic of art, that the saddest subject matter can leave you not just with sadness, but also with happiness. I think, to put a very complex issue in a simplified and broad way, it is the sense of inner freedom achieved after looking with honesty and clarity at all murky issues. So, when you go around to see these works, don't miss out on the sheer pleasure of looking at them. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Now I would like to invite DG sir for addressing the audience.
Sabko pranam. Actually, Patel ji bolne ka baad. Actually, aise college mein kabhi kabhi hum baat karte hain ki Taj Mahal dekhna hai. तो ऐसे कुछ शहर के ऐसे कुछ बात है जो कि ताजमहल को हिला के देखिए तो पॉसिबल नहीं है लेकिन ऐसे बात हुआ था कि नहीं थोड़ा ठंडा लस्सी पी लो और ताजमहल को हिलता हुआ देखो तो ये अगर शो आप देख सकते उसको फील कर सकते मुंबई को हिलता हुआ आप देख सकते हर एंगल से वो कोशिश किए आप ट्रेन में जा रहे हैं चलो वहाँ पर मैं भी देख रहा था एक हिस्ट्री का मतलब मुंबई का हिस्ट्री भी आपको सारी पता हो रहे हैं मतलब हर चीज़ इतना प्रॉपरली नानसी ने उसको डिस्प्ले भी किया है और इतना अच्छा शो है तो आप लोग उसको एंजॉय करना चाहिए सबको धन्यवाद
लाइक टू इनवाइट द चेयरपर्सन Shri Vilas Shinde, Advisory Committee of NGMA Mumbai, to come forward and inaugurate the Marathi booklet and to say a few words.
Namaskar. Actually, today's day is for Sudhir ji because this is his lifetime achievement and he has said so many things in each painting, because when I looked at each painting, every painting has to say a lot. So the in words to explain the visual and visual explained into the words is quite difficult. I lived for a long time in Bombay. I have seen the Bombay life. I have seen the mill workers area life. And you know, I remember when I was in college, when गिरनी का भोंगा जो मराठी में बोलते हैं कि जब ही गिरनी का भोंगा बजता है तो मालूम होता है कि अभी सुबह के 5 बज गए हैं, अभी उठना चाहिए. और लाइफ इतना अलाइव था उसी टाइम पे, जब गिरनी का जो माहौल था, यदि गिरनी जब फुल फ्लेज में चलती थी तो रियली ऑन डे एंड नाइट द स्ट्रीट्स वेयर अलाइव, यू नो, वी कुड सी द पीपल अराउंड द होल बॉम्बे. So here, when I look at his painting, the life of the mill workers and the life of the Bombay train and Bombay streets, and Sudhir ji, really he understood the color theory, you know, which color, what can explain, yeah, the feelings, how he can explain through the colors and forms. That one really I appreciate. And each painting, in every painting, the human figure, yeah, human face, if you see the expression, is very, very different from each other's. And this is how I enjoyed his work. I have seen his work since many years, and sometimes we communicate, we talk each other. Really, I am very happy to see his retrospective, and thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Now I would like to invite Director NGMA Mumbai to share a few words with us.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and I welcome all of you to this stupendous show. Congratulations, Dr. Sudhir Patwardhan, the Guild Art Gallery, Ms. Nancy Adajania, for this wonderful work that they've been putting up for the past 1 week or so. And I, as my brief would go, is largely administering the gallery. So may I take you through all the changes, the positive changes that we've been trying to bring about in the gallery for the past 1 year or so. As Madam has rightly pointed out, we've got the ramp now to make the gallery accessible in all senses to the extent possible. And if you visit the washrooms, those who've been regular visitors to the place, I'm sure, will appreciate that we have tried to raise the bar within the limited resources that we have. Secondly, we've tried to revamp the lift. So I had promised Dr. Sudhir, and we had kept our fingers crossed as to whether the lift would be ready or not. But then I'm happy that the CPWD has also delivered on time. I'm indeed grateful to them. And the lift is ready. The third change is the cafeteria. Well, I don't know whether to exactly call it a cafeteria. You have a food cart, which is a via media between nothing and a cafeteria. This being a heritage building, we cannot tinker with the architecture of the place. So we've tried to innovate and get a via media so that people can always come in, walk, see the show, enjoy, relax, have a cup of tea, and a sumptuous menu too is on offer. And we would be rolling it out in phases. So please do enjoy the place. And we've also revamped the auditorium to the extent that we have a better audio system in place, and we've done branding of mics, because today is the age of branding. So we've branded all our mics so that people do appreciate that it's ultimately the NGMA that's doing these shows. So, and another issue, since we have so many esteemed guests here who work in various sectors, so may I call upon you to kindly encourage underprivileged children to visit the gallery. I think with the kind of resources that we have, art is not just for the connoisseurs. It's also for the commoners, it's also for the underprivileged, and especially the children. So we, as our ministry's mandate, is to reach out to the underprivileged, which is why I have been insisting that all those who are organizing exhibitions here should do at least two programs for the underprivileged. And during the Gandhi exhibition, in fact, we had a bus full of children. It was real magic because they were from Magic Bus and they freaked out, they enjoyed themselves, and you should see the joy on their faces. I think those are the people that we need to reach out to. Anyway, people here will come because they are art lovers. But to kind of enlarge the canvas, if I may say, so is what we should be looking at, and I'm sure all of you here are quite privileged and you will in your own way try and contribute to our cause. So our email is anyway on our website, so we expect some kind of a positive response to bring cheer to more lives. So with that, I would like to end my address, and may I also say that in future what we have in plan is a better CCTV system, which has face recognition, number plate recognition. So those are the features which are like the latest ones that we should have in a gallery like this. We've also installed data loggers for temperature control and monitor. So we are trying our best within the limited resources, and we do look forward to more positive criticism and more encouragement. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. I would like to invite Ms. Nancy Adajania, the curator, to share her thoughts about the curatorial concept.
Thank you, Shruti. I must say I'm quite overwhelmed. We've all worked very hard to put up this show. Shalini Shahani, who has supported this retrospective. Mr. Sudhir Patwardhan, or Sudhir Mam, as I call him, who invited me to curate this show. Thank you. Shanta, who's been with us through everything. Richie, Vinita, Chotu, and all the entire team at the Guild Art Gallery, as well as the NGMA staff, Mrs. Rupavataram, Shruti, and everybody else, who've been with us through this last week to put up this show. So I've titled the show Walking Through Soul City, Ek Sair Ru Ke Sheher Mein. I shall unpack the title in a little while. But first, it is a great honor to curate this retrospective of Sudhir Patwardhan's paintings and drawings spanning 5 decades. His works have always had the power to bring outright joy, pleasure, but they also pose extremely difficult questions of the historical moment. And when we look at his works, we feel that they're extremely legible, that they are also portable, that they carry their social, political context with them. They are not abstract works that are difficult to decipher. And yet, I would actually, while addressing my viewer, tell them that perhaps you need to look at not just the Sudhir that we know, that is, the subaltern figure on the train, at the bus stop, on the flyover, but also the Sudhir that we don't. And the whole point of this exhibition is to defamiliarize the familiar, to look at the Sudhir we think we know, and to look at all the many Sudhirs that we don't actually know. And within this exhibition, I would say that as a curator, one of the tasks that I actually have in front of me is to create a legible exhibition mise-en-scene. And I use the word mise-en-scene instructively. Having been trained in filmmaking and having studied some of the masterclasses that Eisenstein, for instance, had actually written about in film form and in film sense, about how do you actually construct a mise-en-scene in filmmaking, having drawn from those lessons, I have always been inspired in terms of how do you actually create interrelationships between artworks such that they are readable. They may not be readable immediately, of course, because we're not making simplistic juxtapositions, but that when a viewer looks at those interrelationships, they are intuitively able to grasp what the relationship is between those works or the constellation of those works. And therefore, I often try not to actually create a linear chronology. I try to play off works from the past with the present. I also try to play off thematics so that, you know, just when you think that you're actually dealing with the subaltern body, for instance, you suddenly are presented with something which actually, you know, takes you to the philosophical realm. So the idea is to constantly rupture what you think you already know about Sudhir's work. And as I said, the point is to defamiliarize the familiar. Patwardhan, as we all know, was socialized in Marxist thought in the early 70s while studying in Pune. He chose to become a radiologist and set up practice in Thane while continuing to paint and exhibit regularly. Inevitably, he brings his scientific training to bear on his artistic practice. If you look at the work there, you have this very scalpel-like observation of a tumor, for instance, right there on the strap line of level one. So seeing wounds, tumors, is something that we would expect when we look at Sudhir as somebody who has a medical background. But alongside those medical observations of crowds, of collectives, of human beings, there's also another side to Sudhir. He brings to his work an intense hope for a unified field, an affinity for platonic solids and impossible objects like the Penrose triangle. And the reason why he brings in the platonic solids or the Penrose triangle, which actually does not exist in reality but only exists as an optical illusion, is because I would argue that what you have in Sudhir's work is basically an interplay between a very palpable materialism and a philosophical idealism. And I think that this is something that is that I'd like to flag, within my curatorial note here, to say that this is something that perhaps you may want to actually observe in Sudhir's work as you go through these various levels of the exhibition. Now, in this exhibition, just as Gieve actually said, Sudhir has always had this commitment to bring art closer to the public. So, for instance, the Pokhran series that Gieve spoke about, where Sudhir actually painted in this peri-urban neighborhood of Thane, or at least it was the peri-urban neighborhood, now it's, of course, you know, no longer, where he actually painted in the neighborhood, where people would actually be sitting there, he'd be painting many of them, and they would be part of his paintings. And then when he did an exhibition, he actually did it in a factory shed, at a cycle repair shop, in a school, and so forth. He also, as Gieve said, curated a show, Expanding Horizons, much later in the 2000s, again showing the history of contemporary art. And along with that, he also set up pedagogic cells so that people could understand more about art. Because for him, it's very important not just to show art, but to also communicate about art, to have a conversation about art. So pedagogy is also something that's very important for Sudhir. So in the exhibition, you will see this documentation of Expanding Horizons. You'll also see the documentation of Pokhran. You'll also see the documentation for Place for People in the early 80s, the path-breaking exhibition, which Sudhir was part of, and which dealt with the politics of the local. And in fact, what's very interesting is, in a self-reflexive gesture, I found in Sudhir's archive Jamshed Setna's photographs from Debonair. And these are really rare photographs where you have people coming into the exhibition, Place for People, at the Jahangir Art Gallery, and passing comments which are funny, satirical, as well as critical. You should actually read those. This is really a rare moment of the reception of art. You know, which again is something that's very important for Sudhir. Alongside the Pokhran series documentation, Expanding Horizons, and Place for People documentation, we also have something else which is very rare, which is the Magowa magazines. So we have sunboards. We created sunboards of the Magowa magazine covers. Now, Magowa is the magazine that Sudhir contributed illustrations to. And this was between 1972 to 1975. And this was Magawa actually is an offspring of the little magazine movement of Maharashtra. And it had people like Sudhir Bedekar, but also Praful Bidwai, who just passed away, Suhas Paranspe, Anand Fadke, Dinanath Manohar, and many others. So there were artists, doctors, also activists, engineers, novelists, all of these people who came together to form the Magawa group to foreground questions of social justice. So we also have the Magawa magazine covers. So for example, in 1972, when you had the famine, the Dushkal, Sudhir has created a kind of peasant trinity. And you actually see these parched earth faces, for instance. Or, for example, in 1975, he actually shows the parliament tilted sideways. In a way, you might think the parliament is tilting sideways even now, today, you know. So, again, the past and the present are not too far away. So, so we have those covers, again, presented in our exhibition, alongside, I've also provided a context to show how Sudhir was socialized in Marxist thought. He was also socialized in questions related to caste, because Magawa was also carrying articles on the Dalit Panther movement at that time. It was also carrying articles on the Shahada Chalwal, which is landless Adivasis, of which there were many, of which there were great numbers of women who were part of this landless Adivasi movement. It was a peasant revolt. So again, you know, you will find all these different signifiers in the exhibition to show what, in a way, sculpted Sudhir's political imagination in his early days. And then again, this exhibition, as I often do in my curation, is that it's not just about describing the works, you know, but it's also about creating arguments, stories, debates. So it's a jukti tako ar gapo in the Ghatakyan sense. You know, so everything that I actually juxtapose, or the interrelationships I create, should provoke questions in your mind. The same way in which Sudhir's works provoke questions in our minds. And sorry, I've had a very bad cough for the last few days. So there are many rare things for you to see. There are also rare works from the early 1970s. For example, on that strapline, when Sudhir comes to Bombay, starts working in a hospital here, you find how he encounters the poor people living on the streets. And then how, through an expressionist rendering of the human figure, the figures suddenly become distorted, become blurs. This is the phase just before the body turns into a machine-like contraption, in a very Leisuresque sense. So you will see the various phases of Sudhir's work through the various levels, but not necessarily through a beginning, middle, and an end perspective. And just to unpack a little bit about the show, Walking Through Soul City, Ek Sair Rooh Ke Sheher Mein. So walking, when I was studying Sudhir's archive, I realized that walking is a very important trope. Sudhir talks about walking, Gieve talks about walking, Ghulam Mohammad Sheikh talks about walking. So I was also art historically studying, you know, what are the, just as Gieve, you were talking about, what are the words that come to your mind when you are looking at Sudhir's work? I was reading your Daedalus essay, which is my favorite, and also Ghulam Bhai, who had quoted in that essay, Sudhir's works. And that's when I realized that walking was a very important trope. And perhaps also so because of the place for people group as well, the importance of figurative and narrative art. So the idea of actually understanding the other and the environment in close proximity. And walking also, not just to understand the fellow human being, but also to, as Ghulam Bhai says, the creatures. You know, they could be insects, they could be animals, and so forth. Just as this, in this very work, Another Day in the Old City, which you're looking at here, again, it's about, Sudhir had shared this very intimate memory about how his uncle, when he was a child, took him on a buffalo ride, to the Mutha River in Pune. And so that memory triggered off this painting. But again, it's not just that memory, because this landscape turns into an Escheresque landscape. So again, the perspectives are all, they are not exactly the perspective that you expect. So the unexpected perspective, the ruptured plane, all of those things you find in the work. And therefore, I call the exhibition Walking Through Soul City. Now you might ask, where does the word soul come from? You know, because, you know, I mean, why would I use the word soul for a Marxist artist, you know, who doesn't believe in religion? And the reason why I actually inserted this word here is not because, as I remember Shalini asking me, so why, you know, I mean, soul, and also Sudhir asked me why soul, then he said, I mean, would soul actually not be Atma? And I said, no, that is a Sanskrit word, Atma, you know, which is a kind of preordained sense of self. But for me, soul actually is what I would translate from Urdu, which would be Ruh, you know, which is actually not a soaring soul, but a homeless phantom. You know, who's expressing this in Marx's words, the sigh of the oppressed creature. And it's again, you know, because I'm always listening very carefully to Sudhir's memories, to what he has to say about his life's work, and he had told me about how he loves Guru Dutt's Pyasa, this, you know, romantic anthem of revolt. And there again, in Sahil Ludhianvi's, you know, song, you have, Ye dunya agar mil bhi jaye to kya hai? Har ek jism ghayal, har ek ruh pyasi. Everybody wounded, every soul thirsty. So it is all those different triggers which actually come to bear upon the title of this show. And now I'm not going to take more time, but just to say that the various phases of Sudhir's works are presented in this exhibition. So we also mark the important shifts, for instance, from the Bombay riots in 1992, the onslaught of the forces of globalization, the fragmentation of class or workers' solidarity, to also the growing awareness of his own vulnerable aging body and his specter-possessed mind. And with that, I'd like to say thank you once again to the Guild team, to the NGMA team, most importantly to Sudhir Patwardhan. Thank you so much for having me to curate your show. I have learned a lot. It's been extremely challenging. We are both people who are extremely anal. We want to get everything absolutely right and perfect. So in some ways, we are correctly matched with each other. We also are people who believe in rigor. We don't give up till the end. As I was telling one of my assistants, you know, on the show, you know, and I said, you never really leave the battlefield. It doesn't matter whether you're winning or you're losing, but you have to be right there and finish your task. So that's what actually, in a way, curation is often. You know, you have a limited amount of time, and you are, of course, letting your imagination soar, you know, your concepts soar and so forth, but in the end, you are actually working with your own hands. Curation is an artisanal activity. So, in honor of Sudhir, in honor of artisanship, in honor of the working class, I'd like to welcome all of you to see this show. Thank you so much.
And share his thoughts with us.
As Pheroza said, we are all among friends, but I really thank all of you for being here today and sharing in this experience and sharing in our joy. This is just a short personal thank yous. Thank you, first of all, to NGMA, to Garanayak, and Rupavataram Madam for making this possible. Thank you to the staff of NGMA for helping. Thank you, Shalini. She always hides herself somewhere. There. Thank you, Shalini, for persuading me to have this retrospective. Without that persuasion, I would not have fallen in the trap. It's due to your efforts that this exhibition is up today, and a big thank you to all the people at Guild, all of you who have worked tirelessly for making this possible. Nancy's passion and commitment to her work are outstanding. I've seen it earlier, but this time it was a personal thing, so I could see it at a personal level. It's outstanding the way in which she has her ideas clear, and she will, as she has said, see them through. I'm extremely grateful to her. Her curation has brought new insights into the exhibition. I definitely feel that the connections that she has made are new to me, and they will be new to my audience also. Pheroza has known me, as she said, for so many years. We have worked together. It's always been very supportive. Thank you for being there always. Gieve has been the proverbial friend, philosopher, and guide. So he has always not critic. Yeah. So he's always been encouraging me. He's been commending my work, writing on my work. He's one of the best, some of the best pieces on my work are written by Gieve. And he has always been warning me of pitfalls in equal measure. I thank all my artist friends around whose work and thinking has been an inspiration for me. There are so many of you. And all the gallerists that I have worked with. I've had the opportunity to work with many gallerists. I really thank them for their support, sincerely thank them for their support. And I am also grateful to all the collectors who have given me confidence by valuing my work and who have been so gracious in lending their work for this exhibition. Our son Tanmay has given us a lovely surprise gift by arriving for the opening earlier than expected. He was not expected. He was expected later with his family. But there he is. He just walks into the NGMA when we are putting up the work. I and Shanta are stunned. Shanta has been an integral part of all this all along. In fact, from even before I became an artist. So I don't need to thank her. But I would like to say one thing about what my work draws from her. I am a painter of people, which means exploring relationships with people on canvas. The ability to connect with people, a genuine involvement in people's lives, a deep belief in people, coupled always with a critical distance. These qualities I have seen in her from very early on. And they became for me the guide to what I should try to bring to my paintings of people. So Shanta has contributed in a deep sense to the work you see displayed here. Thank you all again for being here, and hope you will come again and see the show at leisure. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Now I would like to request Sri M. Sankar, Curator, NGMA Mumbai, to come on the stage for vote of thanks.
City, a exhibition is declared, and you are free to see around and enjoy. This exhibition specially documented for the couple of decades of Mumbai transformation and all. So it is a pleasure to see this, all the works what Sudhir Patwardhan ji has seen, experienced, and related with the people and city, visual, and what he has contributed for that, how he had reacted for the political turmoils time and again. This is my special observation on this. I know him a couple of decades. Today, it's a very special occasion. All the way, Director General, DG Mr. Garanayak came down all the way from Delhi. And special chief guest as a Dr. Pheroza Godrej ji, and a versatile personality with the multifaceted, talented, great contributor, intellectual, Mr. Gieve Patel ji, and advisory committee chairperson and previous committee chairpersons and other committee honorable members also present today. And I would like to take this opportunity to thank you, Shalini ji, for guide Guild Gallery and putting up this wonderful exhibition. And this exhibition is going to be exclusive for a social subject. It's a wonderful experience because this is a time, these are the images of courageous. And if you see the political situation as in today, and you will notice what is happening in this country, what is the responsibility of a humankind for the what is happening around. And I take this opportunity, especially I thank you for full support from the Ministry of Culture, Government of India, and all other staff. We are known, and on the theatre, off the theatre, overall working with us, making this exhibition by contributing, loaning, supporting, putting up and all. It's a great occasion. I thank you them and all. And I also thank you the press, electronic, all publicity media who are supporting us for encouraging this exhibition to continue it and do our, whatever is possible, our best service for the society as a part of the institution. I also take this opportunity, thank you one and all for you are joining for us now and then, and please spread it a word of mouth to publicize these exhibitions and activities now and then. And we are also going to have many more activities during this period of this exhibition, outreach programs. Please take part and tell people, encourage and all. Please join us for a cup of tea upstairs. Last but not least, I thank you everyone for joining for this exhibition. Thank you very much.